Blackstone presents Swift and Hawk, Cyberspies by Logan Macx. This book is read by Raphael Corkhill. For K-O-R-S-W, who kept on asking about it. Chapter 1. Emergency Exit. Caleb Quinn had never expected to use the emergency exit plan. He went to his bedroom door, listening hard. The voices coming from downstairs belonged to his mum and a woman he did not recognize with a faintly Eastern European accent. He couldn't make out exactly what they were saying, but it was sounding less and less friendly. Something strange was happening. He had just gotten back from school in the center of London, cycling along the Thames side path to his house in Nine Elms. It was the first week of the autumn term. After calling hello to his mum, who was working on her laptop in the kitchen, he'd run upstairs to dump his bag and grab a couple of things. His idea for the evening had been simple. Have some dinner, then head outside to his high-tech computer lab, which was on a barge moored nearby at Nine Elms Pier. There he could spend a few hours working on a big content update for Terraform, the sci-fi action-adventure video game that he had programmed himself. The voices rose. Caleb decided to find out what was going on. He took out the Flex, a super-powerful computer handset that he had designed and built over the past few months. He had been putting together devices like this since before he could talk. To a casual observer, the Flex looked like a pretty standard smartphone. But it was much more than that. Caleb had made it from an ultra-tough, flexible material that could be bent or folded into any shape. It had an operating system that was far more advanced than anything you could buy, with a unique range of special applications and functions. These were activated by coded single-word commands. He murmured one of them now.
Phantom. Mum's laptop.
The Phantom app sent the Flex's eyes and ears elsewhere. A view of the kitchen appeared instantly on its screen, ripped from the camera on his mum's open computer. He backed away from his door and sat down on his bed to take a look. Harper Quinn was leaning against a counter. She was a senior CIA agent, originally from California, stationed at the American Embassy just down the road from where they lived. She was dressed in a pale gray business suit, cut to conceal her sidearm, with a dark blue shirt beneath. Her red-brown hair was pulled back into a ponytail, and her arms were crossed. She was wearing the no-nonsense expression that, Caleb had noticed, she used on colleagues, even more often than she used on him. Across the room from Harper was a very tall woman, at least 6'2", Caleb guessed. Her hair was an angular orange wedge shaved at the sides that blazed brightly in the kitchen's lights. She was dressed like a biker in a black leather jacket, jeans, and heavy boots. A silver ring glinted in her eyebrow. Two men were also visible. One, a huge, bull-like figure, was in the passageway that led to the front door, blocking it off completely. His back was turned, his shaved head almost brushing against the ceiling. The other one, small and skinny by comparison, was standing just behind the orange-haired woman. He had a short, lime-green mohawk and squinty weasel eyes that flicked this way and that, as if seeking some sly advantage. Both were dressed in a similar style to the woman, who was clearly their boss. Caleb studied these visitors closely. It wasn't that unusual for his mum to have evening meetings with colleagues and others whom she described as contacts. But the intelligence people who came to the house were usually more, well, more intelligent looking. He eased up the volume. So, Harper was saying skeptically, have I got this right? You're telling me that you have important information, but I have to come with you to get it? The orange-haired woman gave her a humorless smile.
That is correct, she replied. We have the information you requested, Agent Quinn, but more than this, something you should see for yourself. Please, come.
Harper was shaking her head. Our contact is based on strict secrecy, Ms. Szabo. You were instructed to use the designated drop-in.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.